Hello, Purple Road. We are still here in Carmel by the Sea, California. And we are going to go visit a gallery that is tropical and full of vibrant color and inspired by the flowers of nature. We are going to meet artist and gallery owner, Marc Zimmerman. We are going to be whisked away to a small slice of paradise. Are you ready? So am I. Let's go. Hello, Mark!
What a surprise! Hello, my dear.
How are you?
All is good. Such a blessing. Thank you for coming in.
Oh, thank you for having us.
I'm very busy.
Can I
stay with my passion just for a moment?
Of course you can. As a matter of fact, this is great. And let me introduce you to our viewers here. Everybody, please meet Marc Zimmerman.
Hi, guys.
Our artist in action.
I've got this really cool plant shape that is such a...
That's an interesting plant shape. I've never seen it.
Exciting thing and unusual.
Yeah. Where did you get it from?
It's exotic. Well, this is part of the Protea family. It's a Banksia leaf.
How interesting.
And they curl and twist and everything. But I've got this little thing and I thought it'd be perfect to feature it right in the middle of what I'm doing.
I love it. I'm glad that we caught you in this moment. How exciting.
I love to taper the shape down a little as it reaches the top and make it culminate right there.
Like I am in a tropical rainforest right now. These colors and everything's so lush and beautiful and vibrant.
And this one right here, that's one of my very latest pieces.
This is one of your latest here?
Yeah.
Let's have a look. Gorgeous. And here's the plant that you...
Yeah, it's the same one. It's true. It's become a favorite.
Marc, this is beautiful. So beautiful. So what inspired these luscious, beautiful, tropical landscapes?
The truth is, in my early career, I never wanted to get involved with plant life and botanicals. I didn't think much of them. I was more into, coastal surfing. Imagery, landscape. And other things, still life. But as time went on, the botanical world has been more important to me. And I like the shapes that nature has, but I also like to invent my own shapes and of course enhance color. I mean, there's not much more I need to do.
Well, speaking of inventing your own shapes here, I'm kind of seeing that in this piece here. This is, wow, gorgeous.
Thank you.
Gorgeous, gorgeous.
Thank you very much.
Tell me a little bit about this one, because I'm very drawn to this.
What you can see is a certain cool color palette here of the blues and the greens, and enhanced by the yellows and the oranges. And the pink, of course, is my surprise color. It's like throwing in a wrench to create something a little more exciting and dramatic.
Yeah. Marc, is this something that just really comes from your imagination, or is it something like you have the leaf?
Inspired by the plant world, and yet exaggerated and allowing myself to create inventional plants. And I don't get too hung up on the things of the world.
Famous artist true story.
Salvador Dalí drove a car filled with cauliflower on his trip to Paris.
It is a really sweet, amazing energy in here with that being said.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. And so I'm also seeing, aside from the flowers and the botanical inspiration, I'm seeing women.
And thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she
oh, yes.
I especially see this one here.
Well, let's face it, we adore women, and you'll find them in a few of my paintings. This one is
a
meditative.
Queen. Yeah.
She's really, I call this attuned.
Attuned.
It's attuned. She's attuned to her botanical nature. She's in the jungle somewhere, and she's just connected to the flowers and foliage and in peace.
I feel very inspired by just seeing her. I want that peace and
yes.
that oneness mm-hmm. with, you know, the world and nature and love. That's me right now.
See the female form? Yes, I see that. You resonate right there. In fact, you might not want to move. Can you just stay there all day?
Just stay all day.
Inspire people? Well, this is a cityscape, but I sure had fun with it.
And I love her red hat.
This was Portland, Oregon. I fell in love with the city, the river running right through it. Here's a little bit of a different version of the way I approach art here. I love the faces, primitive cultures, people living simple life down in Latin America and Indonesia and Bali. And as you can see, some of the people have, some of the faces have more than one face. Here's a nose sticking out here with a subtle mouth.
Oh, yes. You could actually stare at this pretty much for a really long time and discover so much very nice mind.
Yeah.
Mark, your studio / gallery is just gorgeous. I feel like I definitely am in some tropical land right now. I'm feeling, you know,
I love your reaction.
Yeah,
I think that's what I want. Great. When I create art, it's about movement. The dance of life. It keeps you moving and swaying instead of just stuck and intellectual. It opens up more of the more primal energies of life, which are, you know, primal is more basic to life.
I agree, you know? I agree. Yeah. So with that said, like for a young artist just really starting off, what would be like the number one advice?
Never doubt yourself as an artist. Never judge yourself. And enjoy all the way. Just keep going and have fun.
That is golden right there.
Keep it simple. In other words, get out of your own way.
Get out of your own way. Just get aligned and let it flow.
Yeah,
right?
Let it be. There's neither good nor bad.
They're
just joy.
To our viewers, we'd love to hear your comments on that. I know that art lovers everywhere around the world, we have, can really add to that and attest to that. Thank you, Mark, for giving us just a wonderful, incredible, beautiful tour of your gallery.
So glad you came in today.
I am so glad.
So much fun. It's like it really woke up something very sensuous in you.
Absolutely.
All right.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you so much for being on the Purple Road with us.
All right.
You and take good care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.